Everybody, please give it up for Nomi, everybody. Big round of applause. Keep clapping for Nomi. They always write, I'm a stripper. Yeah, I'm a dancing, I'm in that business. And, you know, I've worked at both black and white clubs. And I have to make a comment, because I was at work last night, I just had to get this out of my head. You know, normally when black guys come to the club, I think there's a few of them back there. When they come to the club, they, you know, they typically don't really go my route because they want to explore other options, you know, Tiger Woods and all that. So I was like, okay, no big deal. But last night, I did dance for a black guy. And it's kind of like shocking. Even though I'm a Newportian myself, it still kind of threw me off. So I danced up. But the one thing is like, you know, I never can have my shine time. You know, I'm working, you know, I'm gonna keep my shine time, get some change up out here. So I saw a dance with a dude, and let me tell you, I have weird. So funny. So, dance with a black dude, they have a private couch area when you dance with customers. So, you know, I think I'm doing my thing, you know, clapping. New York's gotta work extra hard for this, you know, because they little change is low, because they in a recession. You know, they want to come here. Okay, the change is gonna stay the same. I'm gonna give you to dance to 20, and if you fuck with me, I'm gonna tell these white folks you're in this club, occupying it with them. Anyway, so I saw a dance for a girl. So I'm dancing for them, things like that. You know, I'm doing, you know, here you go. I said, can I please do my goddamn job? Every time I come to work, I gotta argue with y'all and have a goddamn competition. This is my America's best dance crew. Hey, somebody with all that shit. And so what happened? Last week, I danced for, and this is an older white, she was 76 years old. You know, between her and her husband. I'm like, okay. And I'm like, you pick me? And she was like, yeah. I'm like, okay. That's what I was thinking. It was so funny because she was like, old pill, bro. Then she was, cute. I'm broke her ass there. In the back, one black. One white, I was trying to keep kosher. So anyway, how you keep looking at me? We've already talked. We'll be over there. It's still $20 a song. So anyway, the thing is, I was watching, because I was trying to prepare myself for the show, I was watching, you know, a couple of little skits with some little, you know, little comedians that I favor. So I was watching one, I guess y'all seen Shaquille O'Neal does this one where he has all these little comments and stuff. But this is kind of pissed me off. So anyway, it was a dog named D-Ray. And so he was on there and he was talking about, you know, they have this thing called All-Star Basketball. You know what I mean? Like it's this event that happens every year. And yes, we do prepare for it. You know, it's like a business trip. You know what I mean? So he was like, oh, I see you hood, red flats there. I see you hood, red trying to get this money out there. Oh, you know, how did all this start? You know, I want to know, how did all this start? How did it start? Oh, because I'm trying to make me a little bit of change. And all of a sudden, I'm a hood rat, a gold digger. I'm like, y'all started it up in the videos, swiping girls' ass to credit cards and shit. I'm asking for all of that, you know? I was up in there chains and shit, hanging down to that dangling and all that old shit. I can't do all that. You the one driving around with that range. Over. They're trying to give you a little change about it. I'm a little bitch. I'm not trying to get your whole check. But you know what? If you was to come in the club and we don't say nothing to you, they gonna get mad. You know, because you only know you were successful and you made it when a couple of bad bitches walk up to you. You know, if we get up, I'm telling you, we don't say nothing, then it's all, oh, my money ain't good enough for you. Wait, you want the white man, huh? It ain't good enough for you. I brought that up. I was working at Ritz before I got fired. I know y'all like, how did you from the club? It was like before I got fired. And it was this guy, Tay Diggs, was in the club. Was you there to see him? Was you there to see him, girl? Tay Diggs was in the club, girl. And so I was upstairs in the VIP, just hanging out. I wasn't making no money. Just pretending. So I was upstairs, and so we have what you call toast. So he slips me a note. So I open it, I read it, and I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to have trouble because I did do it. We got here early. It was a bit annoying, but it happened. That's not so. So anyway, I open it up. And so he's like, oh, Jay Diggs is downstairs. I say, he's downstairs. Come on, y'all. Why are you going to give me the note? You know, Jay Diggs, he's married to a non-black American merchant. To put it politically, he married to a white girl. What the fuck am I gonna do with this nigga? You know, let him try. So I get downstairs, you know, tiptoeing, and you know how we do, trying to like we don't see him. And so I had to tiptoe over there. So he had his whole little group over there, right? And so that was so nigger. You know how you little white boys get in here with that one leg friend and get on my goddamn nigger. So I had to go over there and try to be nice, talk to him, stuff like that. And so he clamped his legs together. Like he didn't want nobody bothering him. I'm like, you put the wrong motherfucking place to lounge in. This is terrible. You know? So I'm like, okay. So I'm still trying to be nice and cordial. Because in the black clubs, we just say, nigga, let's go. Let's go get a statement. But in the white clubs, we can't do that because, you know, they get mad and go tell manager. You know, but she wasn't professional.
Comedy and beyond, everybody. Give it up for Nomi, everybody. Give it up for Nomi.